Good evening. This is All India Radio and I'm Saira Mujtaba with the news at 9. The headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi hails civil defense organizations and citizens for joining Swachhta Hi Sewa Movement. Panchayat elections in Jammu and Kashmir to be held in 9 phases from mid-November. ISRO to launch 2 British Earth observation satellites onboard PSLV C-42 tonight. Typhoon Mangkhut hits Guangdong province of China after claiming 64 lives in Philippines. In sports, Indian boxers Simranjit Kaur, Monika and Bhagyabati Kachari win gold medals in Turkey. And Kenya's Eliud Kipchoge sets a new marathon world record of 2 hours, 1 minute 39 seconds. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has applauded the efforts and participation of Indian Coast Guard, CISF, NCC and citizens in Shramdan for Swachhta Hi Sewa movement. Mr. Modi hailed the Indian Coast Guard for proactively working towards Swachhta. He said every Indian will be happy to see Shramdan at beaches. In a series of tweets, Mr. Modi congratulated them for their contribution to the campaign. Mr. Modi praised CISF for cleaning coastal areas and said it is a commendable effort by the CISF family. He also saluted the NCC family for their involvement and said this will inspire others to join the movement as well. The Prime Minister also congratulated Swachhta activists Afroz Shah, Shubhajit Mukherjee, Vineet Kumar and Dr. Tapasya Raghav for their efforts towards Swachhta Hi Sewa campaign. The Prime Minister will be on a two-day visit to his parliamentary constituency Varanasi from tomorrow. He will head directly to Narur village to interact with children of a primary school. Later, the Prime Minister will interact with students of Kashi Vidyapeeth. Mr. Modi will inaugurate or lay the foundation stone of various development projects worth more than 500 crore rupees at Banaras Hindu University Amphitheatre on Tuesday. Jammu and Kashmir will have Panchayat elections in 9 phases starting mid-November. State Chief Electoral Officer Charlene Kabra announced the election schedule in Srinagar today. He said the elections will be held on November the 17th, 20th, 24th, 27th, 29th and December the 1st, 4th, 8th and 11th. The last Panchayat polls were held in 2011 after a gap of 10 years through secret ballot. More from our correspondent.
The 9-phase polls will be held in over 35,000 Panch constituencies in Jammu and Kashmir. There are around 4,500 Panchayat halkas with over 58 lakh voters. Main political parties, National Conference and PDP have already announced to stay away from the upcoming Panchayat and municipal polls. State Congress said that conditions are not conducive for holding these elections. Meanwhile, the government has planned befitting security environment to be provided for the forthcoming municipal and Panchayat elections in the state. Tariq Rathir, AIR News, Srinagar.
Yesterday, the State Election Commission announced polls to municipal bodies next month in 4 phases. Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh will inaugurate a pilot project of smart fencing along the Indo-Pak international border in Jammu tomorrow. The Home Minister will reach BSF headquarters at Plora in the morning and launch the initiative, which is part of the Comprehensive Integrated Border Management System. The project, installed at 2 places along the international border in Jammu, will virtually make it impossible for terrorists to breach and infiltrate into the Indian territory. BSF sources told AIR that the Union Home Minister will also visit command control centres and border outposts along the Indo-Pak international border in Jammu sector and review the prevailing security situation. Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar has said talks on seat sharing between JDU and BJP for 2019 Lok Sabha elections are in a final stage. He was speaking at JDU State Executive Meeting at his residence in Patna today. After the meeting, Party General Secretary RCP Singh said, a seat-sharing formula will be announced very soon. He said there is no dispute over seat-sharing between the two parties. Bihar has 40 Lok Sabha seats and JDU won just 2 seats in the 2014 general election. Home Minister Rajnath Singh today said, India is the only country where all major religions of the world, diverse cultures, customs and cuisines are found and people should see and experience this incredible India. Mr. Singh was speaking after inaugurating the 12-day-long festival of tourism, Paryatan Parv, at Rajpath Lawns in New Delhi this evening. Speaking on the occasion, Tourism Minister K.J. Alphonse called upon everyone to see, experience and get transformed by travelling across India. The idea behind the festival is to draw focus on the benefits of tourism, showcasing the cultural diversity of the country and reinforcing the principle of tourism for all. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates, follow us on Twitter at AIR News Alerts. The Indian Space Research Organization, or ISRO, will launch two British Earth observation satellites on board PSLV C-42 tonight. The launch is scheduled at 8 past 10 p.m. from the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. PSLV C-42 will carry two Earth-observing satellites, Nova SAR and S-14 of Surrey Satellite Technology Limited, UK. These satellites will be put into orbit in about 18 minutes after the launch. This is the first commercial launch in arrangement with Antariksha Corporation, the commercial arm of Indian Space Research Organization, in 2018. Our correspondent reports that the total lift-off weight of the two satellites is 889 kilograms.
Novasar, weighing 445 kg, is a S-band synthetic aperture radar satellite intended for forest mapping, land use and ice cover monitoring, flood and disaster monitoring. S-14, weighing 444 kg, is a high-resolution optical earth observation satellite used for surveying resources, environment monitoring, urban management and for disaster monitoring. With the launch of today's satellites, it would be a total of 238 foreign satellites belonging to international customers from 29 countries successfully launched using PSLV. Joy, AIR News, reporting from Sriharikota.
Indigenously developed weapon system, Man-Portable Anti-Tank Guided Missile, or MPAT-GM, was successfully flight-tested for the second time from the Ahmednagar range today. All the mission objectives have been met. The two missions yesterday and today have been successfully flight-tested for different ranges, including the maximum range capability. Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman congratulated the team DRDO, Indian Army and associated industries for the twin success of MPAT-GM. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu left for Malta after completing his three-day visit to Serbia this evening. He will attend the Indian community reception on his arrival in Malta today. Mr. Naidu will hold delegation-level talks with the President of Malta and witness signing of MOUs on mutual cooperation tomorrow. He will participate in a meeting with the Speaker of the House of Representatives of Malta and hold delegation-level talks with the Acting Prime Minister of Malta as well. Later in the evening, he is scheduled to attend India-Malta Business Forum meeting, where President of Malta will also participate. Before leaving for Malta, the Vice President offered floral tributes at the bust of Mahatma Gandhi in Belgrade. Mr. Naidu also offered a wreath at the tomb of the unknown soldier at Mount Avala. It is a World War I memorial located atop Mount Avala. It was built in 1934-38 at a place where an unknown Serbian soldier was buried. Typhoon Mangkhut is now hitting the China's most populous province, Guangdong, hard. With wind speed of up to 162 kilometers per hour, the typhoon had earlier ravaged Hong Kong and claimed 64 lives in the Philippines, a desk report.
Mangkhut, considered the strongest storm this year, made landfall on the Chinese coast near Jiangmen City in Guangdong this afternoon local time. The Chinese state media reported that thousands of people had been evacuated and a red alert had been issued. In Hong Kong also, authorities issued their maximum alert. A typhoon swayed skyscrapers and blew out windows and hurt 111 people. Shops and public services were shut, and more than 800 flights have been cancelled at Hong Kong International Airport. Before heading towards Hong Kong, the typhoon claimed as many as 64 lives. Gulshan Rawat, News Desk.
In the United States, Florence storm has claimed at least 14 lives. Although it has weakened into a depression, the National Hurricane Center said flash flooding will continue over a significant portion of the Carolinas. Some towns have already seen 60 centimeters of rain in 2 days, with totals forecast to top 1 meter in places. Back home, heavy rain accompanied by lightning and thunderstorm occurred at many places of Odisha this evening. The Bhubaneswar Regional Meteorological Office today forecast heavy rainfall for coastal and southern parts of the state in the next 24 hours. Met Office said fresh circulation is likely to turn into a low pressure system over the north central Bay of Bengal by tomorrow, and the rain is likely to continue at most places till the 22nd of September. A massive fire erupted in Bagari market area of Kolkata early this morning. A multi-story building which houses about 1,000 business establishments caught fire. Director General of West Bengal Fire and Emergency Services, Jagmohan, said it might take 24 to 48 hours to douse the blaze. He said they need time to contain the flames as 4 to 5 floors of the building were completely engulfed in the fire. The shops were stacked with inflammable material like plastic toys, fabrics and chemicals. No loss of life has been reported. In another fire in a cracker factory at Kalyani, about 50 kilometers from Kolkata, two people were killed. Police said an investigation is underway to ascertain the cause of the fire. Union Minister of State for Social Justice Ramdas Athawale today apologized for his statement on petrol price hike. The minister, who is the president of Republican Party of India or RPI, said he never wanted to hurt the sentiments of the people. He said he was aware of the problems faced by the common man. In a press statement issued by RPI, quoting Mr. Athawale, it demanded that prices of petrol and diesel be brought down. The United Front of Left Student Groups won all four central panel posts in Jawaharlal Nehru University JNU Students' Union elections, defeating ABBP. N. Sai Balaji was elected the president and Sarika Chaudhary the vice president. Ajaz Ahmed won the post of general secretary, while Amutav was elected joint secretary. The left-backed All India Students Association, Students' Federation of India, Democratic Students' Federation and All India Students' Federation had contested the polls jointly. Assam has joined the rest of the country in observing Swachhta Hi Sewa campaign. Following the clarion call by Prime Minister Modi, the people took a vow to make Assam a complete Swachh state. Our Guwahati correspondent has filed a report on the success of the Swachh Bharat mission in the state.
The Swachh Bharat mission has become a Jan Andolan in Assam. 30 lakh toilets have been constructed in the state and 12 districts have already been declared open defecation free. Due to various awareness drive, people have realized that open defecation is one of the prime cause of many diseases. One of the beneficiaries of the Swachh Bharat mission from Darang district is happy after getting a toilet.
My name is Panindra Sarkar. आसाम का मंगलदोई में रहने वाला है स्वच्छ भारत अभियान का एक हम लोग का शौचालय दिया है आगे जंगल में जाने पड़ता रहा अभी सरकार हम लोग का शौचालय दिया है हम लोग बहुत खुश है
Commemorating the Swachhta Hi Sewa campaign, Assam Chief Minister Sarbanand Sonowal has inaugurated Mission 100, under which clean and safe drinking water to be given to 2.5 lakh people. Manas Pradeep Sharma, AR News, Guwahati.
On to sports now. Indian boxers Simranjit Kaur, Monika and Bhagyabati Kachari won gold medals at Ahmed Komar's tournament in Istanbul, Turkey. Simranjit defeated Selma Kalisken, Monika beat Aisha Kagirer, while Bhagyabati humbled Selma Karakoyun. All those who lost are from Turkey. World Championship silver medalist Sonia Lasher settled for a bronze. Kenyan Eliud Kipchoge set a new marathon world record in Berlin today, smashing the previous best as he clocked 2 hours 1 minute 39 seconds. The 33-year-old Olympic champion, aided by a string of pacemakers, threw to 25 kilometers of the 42.195-kilometer race, took 1 minute 17 seconds off the previous best set 4 years ago by Denis Kimeto. It was the largest single improvement on the marathon world record since Derek Clayton improved the mark by 2 hours 23 minutes in 1967. In the first game at this year's Asia Cup cricket in Dubai today, Hong Kong has set a victory target of 117 for Pakistan. In reply, Pakistan was 35 for no loss in 7 overs when reports last came in. The News Services Division of All India Radio in its weekly bilingual live phone-in program, Public Speak Tomorrow, will bring you a discussion on awareness about drugs banned for human use. This can be heard on FM Gold Channel and additional frequencies from 9:30 p.m. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Prime Minister Narendra Modi hails civil defense organizations and citizens for joining Swachhta Hi Sewa movement. Panchayat elections in Jammu and Kashmir to be held in 9 phases from mid-November. ISRO to launch 2 British Earth observation satellites on board PSLV C-42 tonight. Typhoon Mangkhut hits Guangdong province of China after claiming 64 lives in Philippines. In sports, Indian boxers Simranjit Kaur, Monika and Bhagyabati Kachari win gold medals in Turkey. And Kenya's Eliud Kipchoge sets a new marathon world record of 2 hours, 1 minute, 39 seconds. That's all in the news at 9. Good night.